How Chemicals Got in the Cigarettes, formerly entitled Tobacco Chemicals in Canada. Updated. Written by Daniel J. Towsey. Update January 28, 2008. Since I published this, all lawsuits against the tobacco cigarette makers has been dropped. It also appears that all prosecutors who tried to pursue this were terminated. So I saved the tobacco industry billions. Unfortunately, the fraud of added taxes on cigarettes continues. The average smoker pays $300 a month in fraudulent taxes. The government claims it's in an effort to prevent the consumers from smoking. This is just another deception. It has been proven that the percent of consumers are the same for smokers as non-smokers. Then we were told the money collected would go to the hospitals for the extra expenses to fighting cancer from smoking. Again, this is false. The hospitals never saw the money. Did you know that the cure for cancer has been known for 3,000 years? It was discovered in China. Cancer is a deficiency illness. You lack vitamin B17 in your diet. This was removed from the market deliberately by the FDA. A drug named Letril was created in the late 50s that has a 100% cure within 30 days. This was also blocked by the FDA from the market, since the cancer industry is a multi-billion dollar industry. Guess who owns that too? The money masters, of course. Ever wonder where all those cancer-causing chemicals come from that the government always tells us are in tobacco? Well, so did I. So I suspected that these chemicals are not natural to this organic plant. When I was working on my uncle's farm in Tilwick, Quebec, he was showing and explaining to me about all the precautions that had to be taken in applying such in food plants. He explained that he had to be licensed by the government to use these dangerous chemicals. I found out that his son went to Southern Ontario to pick tobacco plants every summer. So out of curiosity I asked him, "Do you know if there are any restrictions or regulations on the chemicals that are allowed to be applied on tobacco plants?" To my astonishment, he said that there were no restrictions. Now I knew I was onto something. I also later found out that the tobacco farms are so contaminated by chemicals that when a farm stops producing tobacco, they cannot grow food items on this farm for at least 50 years, by government order. Another thing I suspect is that over the years all the chemicals that were produced and found later to be hazardous to human health were applied to tobacco plants. They had a large stockpile of banned chemicals. They thought it would be a great way to get rid of the excess chemicals. Since I felt that cigarettes like food were consumed by humans, I thought that something was very wrong with this situation. So I wrote a letter to the Federal Health Minister, Hun Minister Alan Rock of Health Canada, March 17, 2001. I mentioned to him my concerns. It took some time to get a response. And when I did, he did not deny by points. I was very dissatisfied with his response. And I sent a copy of my letter to many tobacco companies. I later received a phone call from a very interested major tobacco company executive. The executive was amazed at my findings. So I took this opportunity to ask the tobacco executive a few questions. I asked, "Do the tobacco companies have anything to do with the growing of tobacco?" The answer was no. I asked if they added any chemicals to tobacco. The answer was no. So I then said that it's amazing to me how the government knows that they are adding cancer-causing chemicals to the plants and that the government was guilty of hiding this information from the public. I had heard the government in a trial of the tobacco companies that the tobacco companies were willfully hiding information from the smokers, when in fact it was the government doing that. At the time of my communication with the tobacco company, they were losing their cases in all courts and being penalized with huge fines. This was all over the news. Back in year 2000, the tobacco companies went back to court with my information, and all of a sudden all the penalties seemed to disappear. I haven't heard that there has been another judgment against the tobacco companies since. It appears that all previous judgments were cancelled. Ever wonder why cancer for smokers is highest in developed countries? Because undeveloped countries, such as Cuba, do not use chemicals on their plants. October 2005. Please read original article for many links to more information and proof. The end. How chemicals got in the cigarettes.